Good morning, students. Let's do a few questions related with the quantum numbers and the electronic configuration. So first question is there, how many unpaired electrons are present in the following and the elements given are nitrogen, chlorine, phosphorus, argon and bromine. So first there is nitrogen, it has atomic number 7. So it is there, its electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. So how many unpaired electrons are there? So in p orbital, 1, 1 and 1, so there are 3 unpaired electrons in this. Then is the fluorine. Fluorine has atomic number 9, so its configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p5, and if you draw p orbitals, it will be 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now this is one electron which is unpaired. Then phosphorus, it lies in the group of that is nitrogen and has outer electronic configuration here, 3p3, here it is 2p3, here it is outer electronic configuration 3p3. So it has also 3 unpaired electrons. Now next is argon. Argon has atomic number 18, it is a noble gas and it has electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. Then 3s2, 3p6. Now all the p orbitals are completely filled. So it has 0 or nil unpaired electrons. Now next is chromium. Chromium has atomic number 24. Its configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6. Now here it is 4s1 and 3d5. We did earlier also, it has exceptional configuration, half filled, that is 4s1, 3d5. Now what is there? It has one electron in 4s orbital and 5 electrons in 3d orbitals. So total how many unpaired electrons are there? That is 6 unpaired electrons are present there. Now there are few terms related with them, that is paramagnetic substances and diamagnetic substances. So the substances which get attracted by the magnet and have unpaired electrons, that is very important, which have unpaired electrons, they are called as what? Paramagnetic. Now nitrogen, fluorine, phosphorus and chromium are paramagnetic in nature, and maximum paramagnetism is shown by what? That is chromium, as number of unpaired electrons are maximum. Then the substances which are weakly repelled by the magnetic field and have paired electrons, they are called as diamagnetic substances. So out of these, argon is a noble gas which is having paired number of electrons, or they are diamagnetic in nature. Now next is there, how many electrons are there in the elements with Z is equal to 11. What is Z? Z is the atomic number 11, 15, 19, 26. For which L is equal to 1, 2 and 3. Now in order to do this, first of all we will take this first element which has atomic number, let it be X, and it has atomic number that is 11. Now its configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 10, then it will be 3s1, otherwise it is sodium. So what is there? L is equal, should be 1. So L should be 1, what should be there? For what L should be 1, that is L is 1, it means it has p orbitals. Now we are having only one p orbital, then what is there? When L is equal to 1, then p6, then how many electrons are there in p? That is 6 electrons are there in the p. And it is not having 2 and 3 because it is having either s or p. Now second is there, Z which is having 15. Now if we are having 15, then configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p3. The element is phosphorus. So what is there? For L value 1, how many orbitals are there? That is 1 2p orbital, 1 3p orbital. And in this 2p orbital, how many electrons are there? That is 6. 6 electrons are there. And for 3p, how many electrons are there? That is the 3 electrons are there. And in total, how many total electrons are there? That is 9 electrons. Then third is there, then Z is equal to 19. So what will be the configuration? It is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, it is 3p6 and 4s1. 6 plus 4, 10, 10 plus 2, 12, 12 plus 6, 18, 18 plus 1, it is 19. So what is there? For L is equal to 1, how many orbitals are there? That is for 2p orbital and 3p orbital. As for p, L is equal to what? 1. 2 and 3, d and f orbitals are not present. So how many total electrons are there? That is a 6, and here also 6. So total electrons are 12 electrons. Then next is there, that is for 26. It would be any element having atomic number that is 26. So what will be the configuration? It will be 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6. Here it will be 4s2 and 3d6. Count the electrons, it will be 10 here. 10, 20, 20 plus 6, 26. Now for L is equal to 1, how many orbitals are there? 2p6 and 3p6. So for L is equal to 1, how many total electrons are there? That is 12 electrons. And for N is equal to 2, we are having d orbitals. So how many d, L is equal to 2? So how many electrons are there? That is 6. So in total, how many electrons are there? That is 18 electrons are present. Now next is there, in an element with Z is equal to 29. Give N, L, M and S values for 5th electron, 19th electron, 10th electron and 29th electron. So how to do this? For this type of questions, first of all, you will write the electronic configuration of that element. For example, let it be X, it is 29, otherwise it is copper. So you will write it is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, it is 4s1 and 3d10. It is exceptional configuration. In order to give stability, one electron from s orbital jumps to d, so it will become completely filled. So 4s1 and 3d10. So we have to, first of all, we have to find for 5th electron. So it is 1s2, 2s2, 4th, and 5th electron will lie here. That is 5th electron that will lie in p orbital. It will be lying in any of them that will be from p orbital. Then what will be there? That is 2p. So n value is what? That is 2. L value is equal to 1. M value would be minus 1, 0 or plus 1. It could be any value. Or s could have either plus half, or it could have minus half value. Now same way for 19th electron. Now 19th electron will be present here. Here it is 10. 10 plus 8, 18. So this is 4s1 electron is there. 19th electron, 4s1. So here n value is equal to 4. L value is equal to 0. M value will be 0. And s will be either half or minus half. Then next is the 10th electron. Now for the 10th electron, it should be present where? That is again in the 2p6 orbital. So here also what will be there? Now when that will be the same, that either that is n, it is 2p6 only. So n is again 2, l is equal to 1. M could have value minus 1, 0, plus 1, any of them value, or S could be either half or minus. Then is the 29th electron. Now 29th electron will be present where? That is 3d10. So it will be 3d10. For this n value is 3, l value is equal to 2, m could have any value, that is minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1 or 2, any value from them, and s could be either again plus half or minus half. See? Now next is there, next question, in an element z is equal to 36, how many electrons are here with n plus l value 5, m minus 1 or plus 1 and s is equal to plus half. Now for that also, first of all you will be writing the electronic configuration for 36. So it will be 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, then 4s2, 3d10, here it will be 30, now here it will be 4p6. So we have to see n plus l value 5. So here n plus l value is equal to 1, here it will be 2, here it will be 3, here it will be 3, here it will be 4, here also it is 4. For here n is equal to what, that is n is equal to 3 and l is equal to 2. So n plus l value is what, that is 5. And here also 4p6 also we are having n is equal to 4, whereas l is equal to 1, that is total value, that is comes out to be 5. And we have to see m should be either minus 1 or plus 1. So if we draw for 3d10, so there will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 10. So it will be minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1 and 2. So there are two orbitals which are having minus 1 or plus 1, and s should be half. So in this minus 1 and plus 1 orbital there are two electrons, and we have to take plus half, that is one spin. So from here also we should take one electron, and here also one electron, so that will be there. So from this there are two electrons. Now we will see for 4p6. Now 4p6, there are 3 p orbitals, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. It is minus 1, 0 and plus 1. Again there will be 2 orbitals, and out of this one will be having plus half, one will be having minus half. So again from here also we will get 1 and 1 electron. So here also there are total of 2 electrons. So if we will add them, how many total electrons will be there? There will be 4 electrons. The next question is here, why half-filled and fully-filled orbitals have extra stability? We have seen that some have exceptional configuration, as there is in case of chromium and copper in first transition series. So why there is fully-filled and half-filled have extra stability? So there are two reasons. One is the symmetry, that is nature law of symmetry. Greater is the symmetry of configuration, more is the stability. This is the one of the factor. Symmetry, because what is there, when there is a half-filled orbital, all will have parallel spin, and if there are fully filled, then half of them will have parallel spin and other have anti-parallel spin. Then what is there? There is another reason, that is exchange energy. Now what is exchange energy? The energy is released when electron exchange their positions with the electrons of the degenerate orbitals. So when in degenerate orbitals, electron exchange their positions, then energy is released, which is called as exchange energy. So greater exchange energy in the configuration, greater is the stability. So what is there? If, for example, if you are having d5 configuration and d4 configuration. So what is there? First I will take the case of d4 configuration, and you are having 4 electrons in d orbital. Now this electron can exchange its position with this, it can change this position with this, it can change its position with this. So for the first electron, how many exchanges could be there? There could be 3. Now if you will see for the second, first it has exchange, now it can do it with the next 1 and 2. 2 exchanges possible. Then for the third electron, it can exchange position with only next electron, so it will be 1. So how many total exchanges possible? They are 6. Now I will take the case for the D5 configuration, which is half filled configuration. So there is one electron in each orbital. Now if you will see for the first case, it will be 1, 2, 3 and 4. 4 exchange is possible. Then for the second, it will be 1, 2 and 3. Now for the third electron, it will be 1, 2. And for the fourth electron, it will be with the fifth electron, that will be 1. So total exchanges possible are 4 plus 3, 7, 7 plus 2, 9 plus 1, 10. So more the exchange is possible, greater will be the exchange energy and greater will be the stability. So for these two reasons, half-filled and fully-filled orbitals have extra stability. Now next important topic is the shapes of orbitals. What are the different shapes of the orbitals? Now shapes of orbitals depends upon the number of nodes. So first of all, you should know, what do you mean by a node? Node, it is a region where probability of finding an electron is minimum. So this region is the region where probability of finding an electron is minimum. And there are two kinds of nodes. One is the radial or spherical node and other is the angular node. Now what is spherical node? Spherical region where probability is minimum, that is called as the spherical node around the nucleus. And angular node, it is present in the form of plane, the plane where the probability of finding an electron is minimum. And there is a formula for finding total number of nodes that is given by n minus 1, where n is the principal quantum number. Now number of angular nodes, they are given by the value L, and radial nodes is given by formula n minus L minus 1 radial nodes. And if we combine both of them, then we will get total number of nodes, that is n minus 1. Now for example, I am taking the case for the first, that is 1s orbital. As we know, s orbital has been what kind of shape? That is the spherical shape. Now for this, n is equal to 1 and l is equal to 0. Now angular nodes, that is equal to l, l is 0 here, no angular node is present. Radial node is given by n minus l minus 1, n value is 1, l is equal to 0, minus 1, so you will get value 0. So total number of nodes, if we count, then again also 1 minus 1, that is 0. So no node is present in 1s orbital, or you can say in the center there is nucleus and around that there will be probability of finding an electron, and there is no region where probability of finding an electron is minimum. Now if we take the case for the 2s orbital, now for 2s, n is equal to 2 and l is again 0. So angular node will be 0, but there will be radial nodes. And what will be the value of radial nodes? That is equal to n minus l minus 1, 2 minus 0 minus 1. So it will have what? That is 1 radial node. And total number of nodes also, you can combine them or you can directly find it by the formula. So it is n minus 1, 2 minus 1, that is 1. So how can you show this? For example, this I have drawn for the 2s orbital. First it is spherical symmetrical. There will be there spherical region where probability of finding an electron will be there. Then there will be a region here where there is no probability of finding an electron. This is called as node. And after that, again there will be a region where the probability of finding an electron will be there. So in 2s orbital, first is size is bigger as compared to 1s, as well as there is one node also present in the 2s orbital. Then next is the 2p orbital. Now 2p orbital has what kind of shape? They are dumbbell shaped orbitals. So, and this dumbbell is placed in the either in x direction, y direction or z direction. So there are 3p orbitals, px, py and pz. Now for example, we are taking 2p orbitals. Then what is here? N value is 2, l is equal to 1. So angular node is equal to L, that is equal to 1. So there will be one angular node, that is one planar region where the probability of finding an electron will be minimum. So this is the region where the probability of finding an electron is minimum. Radial node, that is 2 minus 1 minus 1, that is 0. So in this radius, spherical radius, there is no probability of finding an electron minimum. So total number of nodes, that will be 1, and 1 this node is, that is 1 node of L. And here this dumbbell shape, it is lying in which axis? That is at the x-axis. Now for py and pz, if we are taking 2px and 2p 2PY and 2PZ. Then what will be there? In this region, that is around this, this is a plane where probability of finding an electron will be minimum. And this dumbbell shape is lying in which axis, that is Y axis. Same way in the PZ, this dumbbell is lying, region is there, dumbbell shape region is there, where the probability of finding an electron will be maximum. This is at the Z axis, and there will be one again angular node, planar node. Now if you take the case for 3P, now in case of 3P, n is equal to 3 and n is equal to 1. So again, angular node will be 1, that is there will be one planar region where the probability of finding an electron will be minimum. But here there will be a radial node also, which is given by n minus l minus 1, that is 3 minus 1 minus 1, that is 1. So how to draw, that is it has having two total number of nodes. One is the planar node and other is the spherical node or radial node, which is lying with the radius. So what is there? There is a, this node is there, where in this spherical node is there, where the probability of finding an electron will be minimum. Again there will be region where again you will get the probability of finding an electron. Now the shapes of 3D orbitals, or you can say 3D orbitals. So D orbitals, there are total 5 D orbitals: dxy, dyz, dzx, dx square minus y square and dz square. Now what is here, in order to draw their shape is double dumbbell. Now how to draw them? In order to draw xy, you should draw a line that is xy axis, and these lobe will be point within this, between these axis, that is x and y axis. Then in order to draw dyz, you should take the two axis, that is y and z, and draw dumbbells in between these axis. And for dzx, you will be drawing the axis z and x, they are lying in between these axis. And then dx square minus y square, these lobes, they are pointing towards the, that is at the axis x and y axis, and there will be two nodal planes. Nodal planes, that is given by the formula L, and for L here it is 2, so they are having two nodal planes. Here also there are nodal planes where probability is minimum. In case of x square minus y square, these are the nodal planes. Now the shape of the dz square is different. It is having single lobe and there is one ring around them at z axis. And in this ring, there is 25% probability of finding an electron. So these are all about the shapes of the orbitals. So do till here, then we will do few things next time. Thank you.